Hey everyone, I'm Hayden Blackman, creative director and studio head at Hangar 13. What you've just seen is our introduction to Mafia 3, an open world crime drama set in New Bordeaux, our version of New Orleans in 1968, one of the most tumultuous years in American history. In Mafia 3, you'll play as Lincoln Clay, an orphan and Vietnam vet who falls in with New Bordeaux's black mob. When the black mob is betrayed and slaughtered by the Italian mob, led by a guy named Sal Marcano, Lincoln becomes fixated on revenge. As Lincoln, you'll wage a brutal war against the Italians, disrupting the balance of power in New Bordeaux's underworld, and ultimately creating a new crime family out of the ashes of the old by recruiting three underbosses, all with personal vendettas against Sal Marcano.
History tells me that giving you more guns might be unhealthy for me.
It's not like that. Not anymore. I'll see to it they get in the hands of the right people.
You're much too serious about all this. It takes the fun out of it. Besides, what's the worst that could happen?
You could get us all killed.
Aye, that I could.
I'll clean this mess up. No reason for you to stick around.
Remember our deal. I'm expecting a cut of everything you bring in.
Hey, I know how this shit works. You'll get your money.
There's Cassandra, the leader of the Haitian gang, who has been trying to get a foothold in the city for months. Burke, who was once loyal to Sal Marcano, but now wants to see him destroyed for his own personal reasons. And Vito Scaletta, who has been sidelined by the Marcanos and wants his piece of the action. Today we're going to jump straight into the middle of Lincoln's war with the mob and his attempts to build and maintain his new criminal family. We're going to start in the bayou and head for the French War. In Mafia 3, we treat New Bordeaux as a main character. We've not only worked hard to capture a unique time and place, but also to ensure that everything the player does in the open world propels Lincoln forward in the narrative. We've also given the city its own diverse criminal ecologies, which play a huge role in Lincoln's quest to tear down the mob. Let's take a look at just a few of the varied districts in New Bordeaux and what lurks beneath the surface and in the back alleys of the city. Our reimagined version of New Orleans is made up of 10 districts, each with its own distinct flavor. We have the scenic and mysterious bayou, which is ripe for exploration. But is also where the Italian mob and their allies run guns and produce moonshine. To the west of the city is vibrant Delray Hollow, which is home to Lincoln and his surrogate family before they are betrayed by the Italian mob. Eventually, the Hollow is taken over by the Dixie mob, who kick up to the Italians and use the neighborhood as the base of operations for heroin and sex rings. To the north of the city is majestic Frisco Fields with its manicured lawns and mansions. This is also where the Marcano family is partnered with the racist Southern Union and cooks PCP at the local university. In the center of the city is the historic French War, a constant party run by Sal Marcano's brother, known around town as Uncle Lou. But it's Lou who deals smack and provides high-class call girls to wealthy VIPs throughout the iconic district. Buckaloo's operation is Lincoln's focus right now, as capturing the French ward for his own underbosses will strike a major blow against the Italian mob. We can hurt Lou in many different ways, but here we've decided to go after one of Lou's pimps, Oscar Sabato, who provides Lou with thousands in cash every week. Before we go after Oscar and his crew, we'll want to resupply, and we can do this by calling in our weapons dealer, an associate who has been introduced to us by Cassandra. Once the mobile store arrives, we can pick out the gear that will best suit our playstyle. As with most of the encounters in Mafia 3, Oscar and his crew can be taken on in many different ways. We can go in guns blazing, we can take a stealthier approach, we can even call in reinforcements. It's really all up to the player. But in this playthrough, we've decided to use my favorite approach, which is going in a little quiet to kill Oscar and then fighting our way out.
You're not gonna find me eating that mess anytime soon.
So we've killed Oscar Sabato, which is a major blow to Lou's cash flow, and will eventually put him into hot water with his brother Sal. But now, we need to get the hell out of here. Here, you can see that one of Oscar's guys has made it to a phone and called in reinforcements. Fortunately, the player can call in a favor of his own from Vito, muscle to bust some heads.
I need Vito shooters near the ward.
Now that we've killed Oscar Sabato, we've cut Lou's earn by more than $10,000, bringing us one step closer to him. We want to keep hitting him where it hurts, but there are many different ways that we can do this. We can destroy Uncle Lou's drug boats, we can interrogate his pimps and dealers, we can rob his bagmen, we can even take over his drug den and brothel. Killing Oscar Sabato is only one of many ways to cut into Lou's action. Once Lincoln throttles Lou's ability to kick up to Sal, Lou trips up. In order to get back into Sal's good graces, Lou arranges a fundraiser for a crooked politician aboard one of his riverboats. Lincoln learns about this and sees an opportunity to kill Lou, one of Sal's most valuable capos.
Ain't nothing for you to worry about. Let's get you upstairs. You're all fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Please. I think we're tilting a little.
If I could get your attention, please.
You gonna tell us what's going on out there?
There was a collision. We don't know the extent of the damage to the ship, but...
When are you going to let us off this goddamn boat?
But my crew is looking into it. If you could just stay right here in the casino. Thank you. The crew will provide instructions on how to make an orderly...
You wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step, he gets it. You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
Thank you.
out there, son. This room, just the two of us. Just don't kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
With Lou dead, the French word is ours. And every time we take over a district in the game, Lincoln calls a sit-down to hand that district over to one of his underbosses to run the day-to-day. In this sit-down, we know that there's going to be a bit of drama, because in this particular playthrough, Lincoln has given a lot of territory to Cassandra while practically ignoring Burke.
You and I are on the line here, Lincoln, and I'm expecting good things. I don't give a flying fuck who has what rockets. This turf, it's mine, goddammit, and I won't accept anything else.
I'm gonna ask you to be patient, Burke, and give everyone a chance to weigh in on this.
I got no idea which way you leaning on this, and I get it, you two got history to call back on. At least one that didn't involve him trying to kill Sammy. But next time, I prefer you cool out with the games and just make the call.
Sorry Burke's all riled up, I know that's a fucking pain in the ass, but splitting this district up like you did just makes things worse. You gotta make a hard call here. And I hope it goes my way.
Do right by me or they'll be hell to pay a chalky.
Trust ain't something that comes easy to me, kid. But I wish it did.
You give this to me, Marcona's gonna shit himself.
We talk about making money, but what it comes down to is respect.
I hope we can get things back on track, Burke, but we're not gonna do it with this part of the city. Vito's gonna call the shots there.
What a sad, miserable fool I am for ever believing in you. But there will be no more of my foolishness. The next time I see your black hide, it will be at the end of my goddamn gun.
You and Burke have history. People between you. But you gotta forget all that and deal with this. Quickly.
The Mick is gonna be a problem. Until he ain't. Understand?
If Burke can't fall in line, ride things out when they don't go his way, then he's not the partner we need. I'll deal with him.
What you're about to see won't happen for every player. But because of the choices we've made in this playthrough, Burke has decided to betray Lincoln, forcing Lincoln to confront him on his home turf.